So tell me, Hector, who inspired you to pursue professional speaking?
Wow, I was inspired by the great Dr. David Mulapo after seeing him in action somewhere. And I thought, wow, this is one thing that I know I can be able to do. I was a radio personality before that, so I was speaking already, but behind the mic. And when I saw him speak, he's standing in front of an audience, and he's electric, it's his energy, it's, you know, it's fire. I thought, wow, this is something that I can do. And I've never been back since, because I even approached him to coach and mentor me into the world of speaking.
Cool. What is it that you like most about professional speaking?
What I like most about it is I like you know, connecting with the audience and knowing that you are making an impact in people's lives. You know, the moments when you are giving this talk, and I know I'm quite a funny person. You know, people just love some of the things that I say, and sometimes I actually do wonder what are they laughing at. But apart from the laughter part of my presentation, the learning part, the substance part, where you can see that my words, I'm stringing these words together, and somehow they are changing the person listening to you at that point, the person looking at you. You see literally change happening as you are stringing these words together, going through your presentation, that this person is giving an answer to something that they have a concern about. You know, these words are solving a mystery in their lives. So that's what I love about professional speaking, changing people's lives.
Great answer. So then what is it that you like least? What is it that you dislike
about? My goodness, that's a tough one because I love speaking so much, 100%. And what is it that I dislike about speaking? I think when I am given a topic that I am not good at, and I'll take the responsibility, I'm forced to take that topic to go and speak about something that I don't know that much about. And the client insisting, this is what we want you to speak about. And I'll try to talk myself out of it sometimes. The client will say, but Hector, we love your energy, your personality, but come and talk to us about this topic. And you find, I'm out of my depth here. This is not me. I'm not really connecting with this audience. Oh yes, and another thing that I do not like speaking, I like about professional speaking. You see, as speakers, well, at least for me, I got into this to help people find themselves. And sometimes you go into an organization where you find that the people in there, bless their souls, maybe they're at the wrong place. Your motivation is fine, you are good, the words are okay, but maybe you are motivating people in the wrong place. The best they could do is maybe leave or go into a different department. But because you are speaking to be paid, you just have to say nice things to make them feel good. But when you don't become really that authentic and say the things that you feel like you want to say because of the money factor, that's a part I don't like.
So why, I mean, you are one of our busiest speakers.
Yes.
Have been for years.
Yes.
Why have you succeeded in a field where so many have not? What do you think it is that has set you apart?
I am real, as simple as that. What you see is what you get. I don't put it on, it's just me. And people love it when you give them you. And for me, if somebody comes to me and says, you are a great speaker, that's not a great compliment. Mm. But if somebody comes to me and says, you are so real, that for me is a compliment. And somebody will say, I can relate to you. I can relate to you. For me. And saying that, you know, didn't come here and tell us about the big boat you own or big private jet you own. You just
been speaking in three different countries
in one week. No. They just say, Hector, you are so real. We feel like we can achieve what you've achieved. You are within reach, you know? And that is why I actually took that word, real. I say, it's all about the results. Because these people will be saying that, you know, you helped me solve something that I've been wondering about. So that real says the results. And it says that there must be entertainment. Nobody likes a boring speaker. Yo, that's why they come to this talk. They want somebody who will excite and entertain them. And that's part of the being real for me. That, you know, I know naturally that's my personality. So I bring it in there and it's entertaining. And then I'm authentic. I'm authentic. Authenticity. And then I love them. I love people. I do it because I love the people I do it for. It's not that I love speaking. I love the people I speak to. So if you love them genuinely, you become real with them.
Just, you know, from our perspective, because I mean, I've been doing this for 20 years,
yes.
And I've worked with everybody in the country,
yes.
Just about.
Yes.
It's such a breath of fresh air for me, for you to come in and just be real.
Be real.
Just be real.
Yeah, be real.
Because that's who we are.
That's who you are as an agency, and you know, real meets real.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And there's no nonsense. There's
yeah.
no nonsense. So now, changing tack just a little bit.
Yes.
Who is your celebrity crush? Who in the world, if you went with who you are now? Who? I will tell you mine if you tell me.
You caught me off guard.
I
oh
know,
my goodness.
That was my plan.
This would be very interesting, but I'll say Bonang.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Okay.
Bonang Matheba.
Okay.
Yeah. That girl works hard.
She does.
She works hard.
She works her tushy off. She really
yeah.
does. What is your favorite thing to do outside of work?
Gym.
Okay.
I have exercise. Anything, you know, whether it's jogging or in the gym, that I like doing that.
Okay.
And, yeah.
Okay. Do you have any hidden talents?
I can dance.
Oh, wow, that's not hidden. We
what?
Know
everybody knows that. Okay, what's the other one that I have?
Funny.
Oops. Okay, I'm funny. Okay, you know that too.
We know that too.
You know, people have suggested that I should maybe try stand-up comedy. You know, but you need to listen to people like Agiso, the guy that we had earlier. He's like, no, maybe not. You know, he's just too good. You know, okay, what else? My other hidden talents. What? I don't know. But those are the things for me. I think dancing and comedy. I think those are people things that. Is there anything else? Maybe I'm a secret. What do you call that? Wardrobe. Stylist. Stylist.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I
enjoy styling people and making sure people look good. Yeah.
Okay. From the good stuff to the bad stuff.
Sure.
What is the thing that annoys you most on earth? What is your pet peeve that just irks you?
Selfishness. Selfishness in all its forms.
Interesting answers this morning. Selfishness.
Selfishness.
I agree.
Yeah.
So now, I'm guessing that I kind of can intuit the answer to this question.
Yeah.
But if you were a crayon, what color would you be? I'm thinking lime green.
Yellow.
So, a little more seriously.
Yes.
If you could invite any three people on earth, dead, alive, or not yet born, who would you invite to have dinner with you?
Dr. Miles Monroe.
Okay.
Who else would be on that list? Donald Trump?
Okay, that's going to be an interesting dinner table.
Yes. I want to go into his mind and really understand him.
There are many people on earth who would say he doesn't have a mind to go into, I'm just saying.
But I would invite Donald for real.
Okay.
My Dr. Miles Monroe, Donald Trump. And there's a gentleman from Ghana. His name is Dr. Mensah Otabiel.
Okay.
I would want to invite to have him, the wisdom of that man. I would want to have him around the dinner table as well.
Okay. That's
interesting.
There are many dinner tables that I want to be at
today.
Do you watch movies?
Not a lot, but I'm very selective about my movies. I don't want your obvious movies. You know.
So then what is your favorite movie?
The Matrix.
The Matrix.
Didn't
even think about that.
Yeah,
just like
The Matrix. Because I think I'm a conspiracy theory follower.
Okay.
you know, and which is maybe one of my favorite things to do when I'm not doing motivational speaking.
You just and I will have to discuss whether they actually got to the moon or not.
Or not, you know, things like that.
Yes, you will.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, a little more seriously, or possibly not, what advice would you give to your 16-year-old self?
Study. Invest in study. You know, work hard. And you know, with that, I think you can go much further in life. You know, in that this world respects papers so much. So, you know, when somebody appears there on stage and says doctor or professor, you know, so and so. So I'll say to my 16-year-old self, study and be focused.
Mm.
Be focused. Don't be frivolous. Be focused. Be focused. Yeah. Study. Be focused. Yeah.
So Robert Frost talks about the paths less traveled.
Mm.
I know you've come from like radio bop into speaking, and then I know you resurrecting radio bop at
yes.
the moment.
Yes.
And much in between,
mm.
where our paths diverged and now they come back again.
Yes.
Are there any forks in your path when you look back on any sphere of your life, any path, any fork,
mm.
that one is stands out more than the others? Not that you regret,
mm.
but that you wonder about. That just what might have been. Is there any one particular one, or are you?
Yeah, relationship, marriage.
Marriage.
Yeah, which ended up in a divorce. It remains a big question for me because I love relationships. I love romantic relationships. I love marriage. It's something that I looked forward to when I was a little boy. And with the choice I made when it came to marriage and with how it ended as well, to this day still it remains a mystery. And not that I'm regretting that I married. I'm glad that I had married, but how one carried himself in that marriage and how it ended, and, you know, the expectations,
mm.
you know, the,
mm.
the expectations that I had and how it ended up being. Ah, man, that's just one thing that is why I actually often avoid talking about relationships. If you listen to most of my presentations, I will touch on it in a humorous way,
mm.
and then I'll get off that subject because I know it's one subject that triggers me a lot, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So marriage, yeah. relationship. Yeah.
Yeah. Which brings us nicely, but you think if we've practiced this, you bring it back nicely to my very last question,
yes.
which is you spoke about
yeah.
your talks and your topics, and if I had to say to you, Hector, I know it's Hector motivated.
Yes.
But if you had to look at your talks in front of you and choose one, what is the one that you love most? What is the topic, which is the keynote that just vibrates out of your soul? Which is
Bishop.
Bishop.
In that it helps me to touch on all areas that I love talking about, because it's an acronym around spirituality, which links to conspiracy theories as well. So I'm able to tap into that while I'm talking spirituality. The issues of health, I spoke about gym,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Mm-hmm.
I believe that, you know, I'm 46 right now, and many people cannot even tell. Yeah, and because of how I eat, my gym regime, you know, I take care of myself. And then the issue of your attitude, you know, that it will take you far. If you have a positive attitude and carry that, which is part of